Hello, Godot is an amazing engine, and whether you use Godot or another engine, I hope this video can shine some light on if Godot's future is fit for your game dev journey. And so today I wanted to lay out the roadmap of Godot's future and what the future of Godot holds. So subscribe, and where does this roadmap start? Well, let's start by talking about the amount of developers using Godot. The most recent GMTK Game Jam pulled in 1,278 games made in the Godot, or in other words, 19% of the total games were made in Godot. Unity made up 59% of the total games, and other engines all combined made up the other 22%. But we really have to compare these numbers to years past. For example, the 2021 GMTK Game Jam showed these numbers. Godot had 13% of the total games, Unity had 61%, and other engines all combined had 26%. So what I'm trying to show you is that in just 2 years, Godot has went up 6% in total games submitted, while Unity has dropped 2%. Now this Game Jam fact is minor, but let's look at the overall total popularity of the engines. While Godot has tripled in popularity, Unity has stayed roughly the same. Okay, so we get it, Godot has been constantly increasing in terms of developers, yes, but what does this mean for the future of the engine? Well, let me tell you. Since Godot is an open source engine, which means its development is driven by the community, the increase in users will lead to the Godot team making much more progress. And Godot really does listen to the community. Just look at this upcoming 4.3 update. It has 300 contributors and hasn't even been halfway finished yet. So many small things are changed to improve the engine in every update, along with bigger things like entire nodes being added. For example, in the upcoming 4.3 update, we are getting a parallax node 2D. Now, Godot is made up of these nodes, and this node system is a huge reason for Godot's success. It is one of those things that once a developer starts to use, they don't ever want to stop. It just makes everything much easier and keeps your scenes much more organized. The system also saves you a ton of time because we don't have to start from a blank slate each time we want to create a new scene. Instead, we can use this sort of template, which is in the form of nodes. And I guess what I'm trying to say is that with more updates, we will get more and more nodes, in turn making the engine easier to use and saving developers from all that busy work of just getting an empty scene set up, since the setup has been done for us in what we could call these template nodes. And since there are more developers, the Godot team will have more support and we will see more and more updates, leading to improved functions, more nodes, more amazing community plugins, and then the word of Godot will spread just like it is now, leading to more developers using Godot, and the process will repeat over and over. So in simple terms, more developers, bigger Godot team with more resources and eyes to help develop, leading to more features that are so important to a developer's experience like the Godot node system, and then the wording of Godot getting out and more developers joining and then repeating over and over. In my personal experience, I thought maybe in the future Godot could add or improve things like a more simple way to go about saving data locally. For example, when creating a save and load system, right now the best way is through the use of resources, but there is still so much work on the developer side that has to be done to make that work correctly. I'd also love to see some tile map improvements and maybe some improvements to the physics engine. Now keep in mind, the physics engine has improved so much here in Godot 4 from the old physics engine in Godot 3, but more can be done for sure, and I know the team is working on it and I'm excited for that. Then maybe an entirely new way to go about shaders, a better way to debug because right now it is so hard to debug without knowing what exactly is going wrong, and maybe a much easier way to go about multiplayer. Although I just said a bunch of things that Godot should and probably will improve on here in the future updates of Godot 4, I believe the future of Godot is bright. I have so much hope for this engine and I'm so happy I switched to Godot 4 years ago and have been able to see this engine grow the way it has so far. Godot is just getting better and better and I'm excited to see where to. I hope this video was able to shed some light on if Godot was the right game engine for you to develop in, and until next time, stay safe, thanks for watching, and bye bye.